All right, we're good.
In general, what do you think the relationship between the police and the public is in Minnesota?
I would say that would be depending on what demographic you're talking about, who you're talking to.
Yeah.
I think it's probably different in different neighborhoods, and different ethnicities probably have to deal with a lot of different things.
Yeah.
I think for the most part, kind of just leave you alone, I guess. I don't know.
Okay. And what are your thoughts on the media's portrayal of the police?
I think it's fair.
Fair?
Yeah.
I think it determines between what news station you're listening
Definitely.
To.
Definitely,
yeah. Okay. And can you name any good things that the police have done as a whole lately in the city, Minnesota in general? Police have progressed or regressed in their ability to police effectively?
Well, I think they've always, probably a little regressed. I think that's largely due to population.
Yeah.
And also with social media now, we're finding out a lot more of what's been going on. So I think it seems to have regressed, but I think also the population kind of dictates. I don't know if there's less or.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, perfect. And can you name any bad things that you've done as a whole in the city?
Anything
that you've heard?
I mean, there's been some killings of African Americans. And I don't think the justice system is always very fair. So I think it's based on if you have money.
Okay. You define community policing?
Community policing? Is that just kind of accountability?
Sort of, yeah. About police being in the community and working with the community to figure out problems as a whole, not just assuming that we know or the police know that what's going on, or that the community has a certain feeling about something, but the police don't feel that way, and getting together and talking about it.
I think they have neighborhood. Stuff like that, which might help, and just getting to talk to police, because sometimes when you go to a beach or something, you maybe just get a chance to know a little bit, because I think a lot of times people are just assuming they're giving tickets out, so maybe just have a relationship.
And what have your experiences been like?
Generally okay. I'm a white male, so it's probably a little different from my story, but I've definitely had some sort of white privilege, I believe. I think I've been pulled over. I've heard examples of my friends that are of color that have been pulled over by cops for sometimes no reason at all, and their cars are searched, whereas I've done something that I consider a ticket and they let me go.
Is there anything you would change to make police be more effective?
What's the question?
Is there anything you would change to make police be more effective?
I guess some sort of monitoring system in place where they're more accountable for some of their actions, and then actually hold them accountable for some of their actions. I feel like sometimes they're judged by a lot softer than if the public would have done the same thing.
Yeah, to get a little leeway. And last question, do you think the police should carry guns?
Right now, probably yes, but I think there needs to be stricter gun laws and guess if a world, the world could be like that.
Yeah. Like overseas, I know they don't have a lot of military guns.
Yeah. Yeah. Those are like, I know, but our country's also more violent.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much.
Yeah.
Appreciate it. Nice to meet you.